I got started by modeling a simple television out of a box shape and a subdivision surfaces object that I'm going to use as a head. I'm using a bool object to subtract one shape from another. That is how I can create a hole for the television screen to fit into. Don't tell anyone, but I chose to design a robot because they're very easy to model. But that is just a little secret between you and me, okay? Next, I designed a simple body and a neck. I'm also modeling this out of a box. Now our robot needs some nice shoulders. I'm modeling these out of cylinders. Select one of the faces using the face selection tool. Then use the extrude inner tool to trace the outline of a new, smaller square. When this is done, you can dig a square-shaped hole into the face by using the extrude tool. Let's get started on our robot arms. I'm also going to keep these very simple. Let's draw a spline using the spline sketch tool. To make our robot's arms, create a sweep object. This object will take two different splines and merge them together into something new. In this example, I'm taking a simple line and a circle. The line will be followed by the circular shape to create a dynamic arm. If you want to change the shape of our arm later on, all we have to do is bend the line. Our arm will adjust its shape in real time. Our robot doesn't have any legs. Let's just create a fun little wheel that our robot is driving on. And a giant clamp that we're going to use as legs, to hold the wheel in place. For our next part, we're going to create some hands. I want to keep these hands very basic. Just some more boxes with a little square hole in them to make them appear more interesting than they actually are. Let's give our shoulders some more definition. It would be cool to turn these into some kind of tires or spare wheels. I'm not so happy about my robot's head, specifically the edges of the TV screen. I want a robot head that's a little bit more square and less round. Let's try to make another one. Just some more finishing touches. This model is coming together nicely. I noticed a problem with the arms. They are bent, but the robot should be in a T-pose. Because of the way that we constructed our arms, we can very easily make this adjustment. I'm happy with the way that this robot looks. Let's carry on with our next assignment, textures.